Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos, and today I'll be sharing with you a brief overview of public versus private blockchain, the similarities between the two, along with the difference between public and private blockchain. So let's get started. First, the basics. A public blockchain is permissionless. That is, anyone can join the network and read, write, or participate within the blockchain. A public blockchain is also decentralized, and that's why it does not have a single entity which controls the complete network. And while many people doubt it, data stored in public blockchain is secure, as it is not possible to modify or alter data once they have been validated on the blockchain. Bitcoin and Ethereum are well-known examples of public blockchain. On the other hand, a private blockchain is a permissioned blockchain. That is, private blockchains work on the basis of access control, which restrict the people who can participate in the network. Generally, it is centralized, as there are always one or more entities which control the network, and this often leads to reliance on third parties to transact. In a private blockchain, only the entities participating in a transaction will have the knowledge about it, whereas others on the network will not be able to access it. Hyperledger Fabric of Linux Foundation is a perfect example of private blockchain. So now, as you have got a little overview of the subject, let's pin down the similarities of public and private blockchains. Number 1, both functions as an append-only ledger, where the records can be added but cannot be altered or deleted. Hence, these are called immutable records. Number 2, each network node in both of these blockchains has a complete replica of the ledger, as both are decentralized and distributed over peer-to-peer network of computers. Number 3, in both, the validity of a record is verified, thus providing a considerable level of immutability until the majority of the participants agree that it is a valid record and reach consensus. This further helps to prevent tampering with the records by any third party. Number 4. Both blockchains rely on numerous users to authenticate edits to the distributed ledger, thus helping in creation of a new master copy which can be accessed by everyone at all the time. Moving further, let's discuss the major difference between public and private blockchains. First, the order of magnitude of public blockchain is lesser than that of a private blockchain, as it is lighter and provides transactional throughput. Whereas in private blockchain, order of magnitude is more as compared to the public blockchain. Next, in public blockchain, anyone can take part by verifying and adding data to the blockchain. Whereas in private blockchains, only authorized entities can participate and control the network. Further, a public blockchain is decentralized, whereas a private blockchain is more centralized. Public blockchain can't make use of consensus algorithms, but private blockchain can use consensus algorithms such as proof of elapsed time, RAFT, and Istanbul BFT. Next, transactions per second or TPS are lesser in public blockchain when compared to private blockchain. As the number of authorized participants is less in private blockchain, it can process hundreds or even thousands of transactions per second. Next, a public blockchain cannot compete with a private blockchain in terms of scalability issues, as it is slow and hence can process transactions only at a slow pace. Whereas in a private blockchain, as only a few nodes need to manage data, transactions can be supported and processed at a much higher pace. Next, public blockchains are trustless, and usually in a private blockchain setup, participants must not trust one another. Simply because in a private blockchain, the validity of records cannot be independently verified, as the integrity of a private network relies on the credibility of the authorized nodes. Next, a public network is more secure due to decentralization and active participation, simply due to the fact that it has a higher number of nodes in the network, and it is nearly impossible for bad actors to attack the system and gain control over the consensus network. On the contrary, a private blockchain is more prone to attacks, risks, and data breaches or manipulation, and it is easy for bad actors to endanger the entire network just by accessing the central node. Next, a public blockchain consumes more energy than a private blockchain, as it requires a significant amount of electrical resources to function and achieve network consensus, whereas a private blockchain consumes a lot less energy and power. Next, In a private blockchain, there is no chance of minor collision as each validator in the network is known and they have the suitable credentials to be part of the network. But in case of a public blockchain, no one knows who each validator is, and this increases the risk of potential collision or a 51% attack, where a group of miners who control more than 50% of the network's computing power can influence it. Lastly, do remember, as security measures for public blockchains become stronger by each passing day, their value will further increase, making the use of private blockchain less essential. However, when it comes to having more control and the ability to restrict access to specific individuals, private blockchains can't be beaten. In the end, the choice of whether to use a public or private blockchain for business lies with each organization that utilizes it and their respective use cases. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, be sure to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.